Amen.
Good morning. My name's Irwin Carmichael. I was born and raised on Beatty's Ford Road, and I am running for Mecklenburg County Sheriff on the Democratic ticket. And I started with the sheriff's office in 1986. And when I started with the sheriff's office, we only had 75 officers. Today, we're 1,300 employees. And right now, on a daily basis, we house around 1,900 inmates. And a lot of people don't realize we're going to return 95% of them back out into the community. And it is our goal, when we return them, we want to return them as productive members. We want to give them the tools to succeed. We want to turn them into taxpayers, not tax burdens. How do we do this? It's actually through our programs that we have. And we have what's called, we have a culinary program, we have a carpentry program, we have a horticulture program. When these inmates are released back out in the communities, we've actually been able to partner, okay, with the workforce to where they have jobs. So they're not going to return back into our facilities. That's the first step. The second step is we never have a chance to affect kids until ages 16 and 17, our youthful offenders. We right now in the state of North Carolina, we have the only high school diploma system in our jail system in Mecklenburg County. And I want to expand that. So, and the third thing is, again, kids, a recent stat came out that 50% of African Americans, 40% of Caucasians will be arrested by the age of 23. We got to change those stats. How do we change them? Is we need to reach these kids at a young age. We need to reach them in kindergarten, TK, pre-K. Give them the tools to do the right thing the first time, every time. And how do we do this? Is we're going to do this by partnering with CMS, private schools, homeschoolers, and the faith community. Another stat that just recently came out is kids that are involved in the faith community have a very, very low percent of offending. So we need to be involved. We need to connect with them. And again, I've been with the sheriff's office 28 years. I'm currently a captain with them. I love this community. I love public service, and I would just be honored to be your 44th sheriff of Mecklenburg County. Thank you. That is a program that we want to return. It's the Work Release Restitution Center. This is where they're able to give back to the community. Okay, and pay their restitution. And this is where we're able to partner with the workforce where they're able to work, they're housed, and they're not going to reoffend. Okay, once they are released, they're not going to come back in. So absolutely, I want to continue that, and I want to expand it. We have a 150-bed facility, okay, and I would like to fill every bed up for the work release program. You're looking at only one segment of our responsibility in regards. It's not 1,300 employees for 1,900 inmates, because we run 80% of our business is running our detention facility, but we also run the courthouse security, where right now almost 1.2 million people, visitors, come through the courthouses. Last year, our officers, our deputies, stopped 15,000 contraband items just from coming through our courthouse facility. Then also we're running civil process. Okay, we run the civil process, we run the gun permitting, purchase permits. So we're tracking right now 980 sex offenders in Mecklenburg County. So there's far more responsibilities with those 1,300 employees than just the detention facility. Right now, it's about $45,000, okay, to house an inmate in our jail system. And if you look at the savings, at one time, we were at close to 3,000 inmates. And over the years, in the last several years, we have been able to change that number through the justice system, okay? Partnered with the judges, the attorneys, if you look at CMPD, the sheriff's office, the programs that we're putting out there, that's why that our inmate population has dropped from close to 3,000 down to 1,900. We want it to continue to go down, okay? Because we want to be, it's cheaper for us to keep them in the community than it is to house them in our facilities. And like I said, we want to give them the tools to succeed. We want them to, again, be productive members of society. And our programs are very, very valuable. Our vocational programs, like I said, the culinary, the carpentry, the horticulture, take Metro Atlanta greenhouses. They are waiting just for these people who are released to immediately come to work in their facilities. We're doing certifications program, a ServeSafe program, which is a restaurant. We recently had a person from Department of Corrections. He came into our facility. We gave him we trained him up to the ServeSafe level certification. 2 days after he was released, he was employed. And that is our goal, because we have counselors that are immediately trying to partner with the workforce out there so they can be employed just as soon as they're released and through the certification. It is our goal to clear out our jails. I mean, we don't want to build no more. We do not want to build more jails. Our goal is to clear out our jails. And how we're doing this is, again, is giving people the proper tools to succeed, training them to where when they are returned back out into the community, that they're going to be able to not reoffend and come back into our system. There are some evil people in the world, okay? And we're going to have to, those people there need to stay in our facilities. That is the reason that we have it. So it would be nice. I always tell everybody it'd be great. There's two elements always have to exist for any crime to happen: intent and opportunity. Intent, we have no control over. If we did, I would be out of business. Because what I do, I would go to the Mecklenburg County Jail, reprogram all prisoners to be good. But that's not reality. Opportunity is the only thing that we have control over. It would be nice to be able to reprogram them, but there's some of them that we just cannot do. Okay, but it is our goal, and this is one of my goals, is I want to create as much space in our jail. I want to clear it out as much as possible. And one of the ways, again, is connecting with the faith community. I actually want to create a faith advisory board. That what we can do with this board is find out what are the needs to the community, okay, that we can reach out to them, okay, and to connect with them, and again, to train these kids. We got to get to them at an early age so they never come into our system. And there's only two counties in the state that the sheriff is not the rural patrol. That is Gaston County and Mecklenburg. Okay, so in Mecklenburg, like I said, our main priority, 80% of our duties is detention, is our detention facilities. And then again, we also take care of the courthouse security, and we also take care of the civil process and gun permitting, sex offenders, okay, tracking all of those and the registries for that. And a great thing, with 980 registered sex offenders in Mecklenburg County, if you want to know where they are, just go to the Meck Sheriff website, okay? We're tracking every one of them. And if you register your email address on our website, if we register a sex offender within 1 mile of your home, we will email you. We will notify you, okay? So that is a great tool, a great resource, okay, for you. But again, the Mecklenburg County Sheriff's Office, okay, and Gaston County, the only two counties in the state, the sheriff is not the rural patrol.